What's up, creative people, and welcome back to the channel. I'm Jay Wells, and I would like to welcome you to Create Something Every Day. If this is your first time tuning in, make sure you join us. Join us on the journey. So go ahead and hit the subscribe button. Make sure you hit the bell so you can be notified. And don't forget to like and comment down below and share your thoughts on some of the topics that we touch on here on the channel. So today I'm going to show you guys one of the things that I do here from scratch. I put it together and I go with that. Take a regular box and turn it into a light box, so I can get perfect shots, just the photo of the product itself. I particularly like to stick with white or black because it adds more of a professional look to the photo when it's finished after you take it to post and do the things that you need to do to enhance this photo to give it the look that you're looking for. Okay, creative people, so here go the fun part. So I'm gonna show you guys the items we're gonna use today. Ooh, nice size. I got a 22 by 16 by 8 box. So that's my box. So we're going to need a box, packing tape, regular packing tape, nothing special. Whatever packing tape you can get your hand on, this will do. We're going with packing tape. A blade. Me, I picked this up at Home Depot. This is a blade that's universal. You can cut boxes. I use the open wrappers and I use it in my projects as well. But you're going to need yourself a blade. Scissors may do, not too sure, never used them. But I will go with a blade. Make sure you be careful. Make sure you read the rules on how to correctly use these blades before you go ahead and start putting them to the test. Safety first. So LED light. This is the light that I have. It's one of the lights that I used to throw on my cameras and run and gun when I was out in the field getting footage or photos, and I would use it for spotlight. But you're able to dim it, turn it up and down. It's a little button on the side. But whatever light you have, this is for my hole that I'm gonna cut on the top of my box and use this for spotlighting, okay? So I'm going with a one light setup today to show you guys this example, and this is the light that I will be using. Hopefully you guys have something that you can use. If you have LED lights that can extend, maybe you can put it over top. Maybe you'll do something or come up with something. Put it in the comments. Let me know what you did to make your light box work if you did this technique. And you also have to have your poster board. So this is the poster board that I got from the dollar store. Right in the arts and crafts section, I found this sitting back there, ready for the light box build. Now I pre-cut these ones already, and this is just for the sides of the boxes, stuff like that. Sides of the boxes, because the bigger portion is gonna be your slope. So that's all we're gonna need to get the base of this done. So hey, creative people, here we have our light box that we're gonna use for product photography. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment down below. Let us know some of the tips that you guys use when you're doing home product photography or any tricks that you may know that enhance this thing here. It works for me, hopefully it works for you guys, and I'll see you on the other side, which is the other video. Make sure you create something every day. Hit that bell for the notifications. I'm out of here.